Another strange idea from Sandy Adams. Adams supports plans to privatize Social Security and Medicare, risking our retirement on the reckless ways of Wall Street.
This new ad is from Democrat Congresswoman Suzanne Kosmas and is aimed at scaring voters away from her Republican challenger, Sandy Adams. Let's bring up the truth meter on the first part of this claim. Does Adams support plans to privatize Social Security? The truth meter rings false, and here's why. The super fine print in the ad refers to a questionnaire and interview Adams provided in August to the Examiner.com. Adams was asked for a solution to rising costs for Medicare, not Social Security. Adams answered by saying she liked some of the ideas put forth in Wisconsin Congressman Paul Ryan's Roadmap for America's Future. While Ryan does in fact support the idea of people investing a portion of their government retirement, Adams has made it clear that she believes Social Security needs to be reformed, but that does not mean privatized. And right here on her own website, she clearly states Sandy Adams opposes the privatization of Social Security. The second part of the claim is that she supports privatizing Medicare. We'll bring up the truth meter again on this. Does she support that? The meter is going to hold in hover mode, though. We really don't know. Her own website makes no mention about Medicare under the issues category of health care. But again, she said she liked some of the ideas in the Roadmap to America's Future, Congressman Ryan's plan. An analysis by the Washington Post indicates government spending under the Ryan plan on Medicare would be cut by more than 65% by the year 2080. But that can only happen by shifting the financial risk from the government to seniors.
Adams would give millions of our money to the big banks that wreck the economy?
Since there's no reference at the bottom of this claim, I contacted the campaign staff of Congresswoman Suzanne Kosmas to find out what they were talking about. Turns out it's another reference to privatizing Social Security, which, if that ever happens, would potentially put savings at risk. People would invest some of those dollars themselves, and investments most often do not guarantee returns. But there's no need for the truth meter on this. As I mentioned a moment ago, Adams is on record as saying she is against privatizing Social Security. With the WESH 2 News Truth Test, I'm Greg Fox.